What up, though? B-Tech back with another video. So glad to be back. Today, we're gonna talk about my three most favorite features that's coming to FaceTime with iOS 15. Please consider subscribing if you enjoy me explaining tech in the way that... Please consider subscribing if you like videos where I explain tech in a simple enough way that even Granny can understand. All right, cool, let's get it. So as you know, or maybe you don't know, Apple releases an iOS update every year for watches, iPhones, MacBooks, iPads, and everything like that. So this year is the 15th year of that. So we get iOS 15. There are so many changes being made to not only every part of iOS, but there are some big changes being made even to FaceTime. So many big changes that I had to dedicate a whole video to. Today we're gonna talk about my top three favorite features of FaceTime on iOS. The first feature that I'm gonna talk about is about mic control. Now, while we're FaceTiming, there isn't really much mic control that we have other than body, but in iOS 15, you get two modes where you can have more control over your mic. The first being voice isolation mode. Now, this is pretty self-explanatory, but I'm gonna explain it anyhow. So basically, when you turn on this mode, the camera and the mics will focus only on voices and not background noise. Anybody that's been in a busy environment with FaceTime on, they can tell you that it's very hectic. You have to keep saying, hey bro, can you say that again? Huh, I didn't hear you. Let me just text you. I'ma call you or something like that. Now with voice isolation mode, you should be able to knock all that background noise out of the way and you can actually focus on the call. Second, microphone mode that you get is wide spectrum mode. Now this does the opposite of what voice isolation mode does. It focuses on everything, including everything in the back. So you can think about it like if you are playing the piano and singing at the same time and you want your friend to be, you know, kind of like in the room with you. They'll be able to hear the piano, the singing, everything, no problem. These features sound great on paper. I need to see it in action. You know, I never thought I would see the day where Android users would be able to use FaceTime. But now in iOS 15, you can schedule out FaceTime calls for future dates, and somebody that has an Android phone or somebody that's working off of Windows, they'll be able to log into their browsers and use their camera that's connected to their device and actually be on FaceTime. How about that?
How about that?
How about that?
How about that?
The reason I love this so much, we don't have to use a client like Zoom. Now we have it already on our phones, and you can have group FaceTime calls with people that don't necessarily have apps. I guess my only thing is I wish that you could share your screen while you have all these people on the phone, right? That would be amazing. Would you look at that? Screen sharing is now available on FaceTime. Now, before anybody from the Android community says something like,
man, we've been had that feature since 1976. Y'all Apple, y'all need to catch up, bruh.
I just want to say that this is a notable feature, but it actually is not my favorite. And it segues into my most favorite feature of FaceTime on iOS 15. And that is SharePlay. Now, when you're on a group FaceTime call and somebody's watching Netflix, or TikTok, or Disney Plus, or HBO Max, we can all watch it actually at the same time. Let's say that I have five of my friends and we are on FaceTime and we wanna watch something on HBO Max. If I pause it, it pauses it for everybody. If somebody says, hey, can you go back 10, 20 seconds? It goes back for everybody. It's totally in sync. This works for all of the services that I mentioned, but also Apple Music as well. So let's say somebody dropped, we're still waiting on the Donda album, Kanye. Still waiting. I don't know when that's gonna drop. Next year sometime, I don't know. Anyway.
Never gonna get it, never gonna get it, never gonna get it, never gonna get it.
If I'm on FaceTime with one of the guys and we wanna check out the Donda album or something like that, we can literally see each other's reactions as we're listening to it. During this pandemic, everybody's social life has changed. It's about time that technology has caught up with us. This is my favorite feature because it helps you strengthen community even when you can't be there in person. Well, these are my top three favorite improvements of FaceTime within iOS 15. I hope that you've been able to learn something from this video. And again, if you like this type of content where I keep tech simple, please consider subscribing and sharing with a friend. Until next time.